The embryo transfer is a technical step that involves various components. It has nothing to do with how we prepare the endometrium or how we select patients based on their uterine anatomy and so forth. It has something very much to do with on-site at the moment of having the embryo ready for transfer, doing the best you can in order to get the embryo to where it needs to be in the safest way. The dynamics of large group practices are such that often one single physician will do all the transfers at any given day or week or time interval. And one would hope that within the department one could shift the responsibilities towards those that are talented and have the better pregnancy rates versus leaving those out that or reducing their volume or do some other internal adjustment towards those that may not be so good at it. Unfortunately, the criteria as to who gets to decide those things are not always simply established on performance rates alone. The chief of the department versus the director of a department versus somebody with a certain background and reputation may be the preferred transfer based on the patient's request, who may not know internally what is happening in terms of their success rates based on the transfer alone. The patient has usually very little input on that because that's not part of any published data of any clinic. Or you have to assume, basically, if you go to a program and there are multiple physicians are involved, their pregnancy rates are quoted as a group. The question that, as a patient, I would recommend should come up is, how much importance do you put on the actual embryo transfer? Where do you do the procedure? And who does the procedure? And do you keep track of embryo transfer technique-related statistics? One could ask that as a patient. Do you use ultrasound for embryo transfer?